the type of data robot learning needs has to be a lot more flexible and has to contain real physics so a robot knows how to interact with the world. As it turned out, there are these things called generative models that can produce realistic and very diverse images on demand if you tell the model what you want in the language we speak. So our key insight is that we can use these generative models as internet-scale data on steroids or internet-scale data on demand and use these models to generate the data for the robot to learn from. This is what the robot sees. Each frame is rendered with a generative model. By flashing between different visual experiences, the robot gains an understanding of the many ways the world might look. So our research program is called LucidSim. It's a simulated learning environment for like robots to learn how to do visual parkour from generated images. If you really want household robots that can live in the same room as we do, you need robots that have legs. The impact of our research is to give robots the mobility it needs to operate in the places like us humans live in.
Typically, people use image generative models to make art. But here, what we want to do is teach the robot how to master its environment. What we really want is to have the physics from the physics engine drive the image generation process. And the complication here is that you typically don't have any control over the composition of the image that you produce. Fortunately, turns out there's this technique called ControlNet, which allows you to control the composition of the image through means like depth or semantics. So that's how we make these images realistic, physics-wise. The second problem that we faced is that we want the robot to take in a series of images rather than a single frame. So we developed Dreams in Motion, which helps us generate subsequent frames from a single generated image that aligns with the robot's movement and experience. So there's this technique called image warping, which amounts to moving around the pixels in an image in accordance to changes in a robot's camera perspective.
If you just teach the robot using data from another robot, actually wouldn't work very well. So it's really, really important for the robot to learn from its own data that's generated by its own actions. And this type of data is called on-policy data. So with this paper, we show that on-policy data is responsible for most of the performance of the robot that's learning in the end. If we look at robotics as a whole, there are really three problems that we have to solve. The first problem is how to produce robust and performant policies, and that's LucidSim. Once you master individual policies, then the next question is how you can get the number of skills you need so that when the robot enters the real world, it doesn't have to learn new skills on the fly from scratch. Now, the third problem is a little bit more subtle, and I believe the hardest problems in robotics are not problems in robotics, but problems with intelligence itself. So the final part of this program is to expand what LucidSim does on individual skills to an entire quest that involves many, many steps. And the goal of the third step is to give robots the ability to handle these long horizon tasks and to reason about and to explore the open world at its own will. We're so excited for you to see LucidSim and what these robots are capable of doing in the real world. I truly believe that this is how you'll be training your robot in the future, that is, to learn from generated data.